Welcome back. Now look at the other events in the state.
A delegation of farmers along with NGO and activists from Fatorda met the South Goa collector. They complained that upcoming constructions in the area have damaged their agricultural farms. The Marga Vanamahotsav Committee and the Deputy Forest Conservator's Office organized Vanamahotsav at Kolmarod in Naveli. The Deputy Conservator of Forest Sunit Bakshi, the Chief Officer MMC Srinath Kotwale, Vice Chairperson Pratima Kutino, and ex-MMC Chairperson Savio Kutino were present. Saplings were planted and also distributed to the residents.
We have organized this program as to promote tree plantation. As we all know, pavasat ami zada roitat, ani zada kityak roitat, soil erosion lagla gon. झाडां कितली रोयता तितले ऑक्सिजन सप्लाय बरो जाता एंड दिस वी हॅव इट एव्हरी इयर.
गोवा सुराज पार्टी हॅज ऑपोज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉप्युलर स्कीम्स ऑफ परिकर लेड गव्हर्नमेंट, द लाडली लक्ष्मी स्कीम. जनरल सेक्रेटरी ऑफ गोवा सुराज पार्टी फ्लोरियन लोबो सेड दॅट इट वॉज वेस्ट ऑफ टॅक्सपेयर्स मनी.
टॅक्सपेयर्स मनी इज बीइंग वेस्टेड ऑन दीज ग्रँडियोस स्कीम्स वेअर द गव्हर्नमेंट is interested in getting the girls married through the taxpayers' money.
First Kokani pop audio album CD of Chitra Shirvoikar was released by Priyanka Birie. Rajendra Talak was a chief guest. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
Now the news from sports. Goa Football Development Council has officially begun operations from its new home in Pato. Sunday marked the inauguration of the office premises, followed by the first meeting of the general body. CM Manohar Parrikar, who was present for the inauguration, agreed with Chairman Dr. Rufin Montero that the GFTC should set up a team of medicos to tackle the innumerable injuries faced by Goan footballers. A small quota of jobs reserved specially for footballers, pension for former state players, and of course an all-out approach to develop football from a tender age.
At 11 a.m, the office premises of GFDC were inaugurated by the hands of CM Manohar Parrikar, who not too long ago declared football as the state sport. The banner was unveiled, lamp was lit, and the cake was cut by all the dignitaries.
But GFA cannot take care of everything. For example, what happens to a player after he retires, like me? I am also a player.
But what happens to these players who are retired afterwards? Those other than Dempo or these top teams, what happens to them? I think Football Development Council will look after how to ensure that a player feels confident and his father and mother tells him, go, sir, go and play football, don't worry. There will be something for you once you retire. So there should be direct recruitment of some particular number of sports persons, including footballers. जर आम्ही वर्षात 2000 लोक कामात दवरता जाल्यार सांगले भितरले 0.5% वाय डोंट वी कीप इट डायरेक्टली एडमिसिबल फॉर अ प्लेयर ऑफ अ पर्टिक्युलर स्टँडर्ड.
All high-profile football and sporting personalities attended the function, along with Sports Secretary Keshav Chandra and other bureaucrats. Former footballer and Aldona MLA Glenn Ticklow was also present. Dr. Montero officially unveiled his panel on the occasion before having the first ever general body meeting.
Second is development of a good sports medicine setup in Goa, which we do not have right now. We are trying to formulate a pension policy or some monetary aid policy for players who have played for Goa and who are not well off now.
Questions have been raised as to why a journalist is included in the executive committee of the council.
Now the
council
has taken a decision.
We have taken that decision.
The council has taken a unanimous decision here that whatever is discussed in the council will not be reported by anybody except by the person who is addressing the press, that is the chairman and the member secretary, and nobody else.
Sports reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Dinesh Karpe from Panji.
Energetic, exciting and highly skilled Dempo midfielder Godwin Franco feels his time has come to play regularly in the I-League. The former Pune FC man is beginning to feel itchy after he sat the bench for most of last season's I-League. Godwin claims whenever he played, he performed, and his record is a testimony to that. The Guiri-based lad was in Europe until last week, where he gave trials for several clubs in the bargain. But despite showing keen interest in Godwin, the midfielder claims he cannot make the transfer as he is bound by a contract with Dempo.
Godwin Franco visited Germany and a few countries, but claims he could not accept those offers owing to his contract with Dempo.
Godwin, you were on trials in Germany and a few other countries. Could you tell us what that experience was like?
Well, Europe is the household of world football, and it's very professional, and I've been training with very good clubs in Germany who had shown interest in me, but then since I have a contract with Dempo, I could not talk to them, but then they've want me back next year.
Dempo's number 7 is itching to get more playing time in the I-League. Lack of playing in the I-League is hampering his India duties, feels Godwin.
This is one very important decision, because this year anyhow I have to play, and this is one thing that I want to see happening. So, but they've spoken to me here also at Dempo that I will be playing this year regularly. They want to play me, but then I will see before the I-League starts what the situation is. I've got clubs, other clubs in very good clubs of India who've already spoken to me, and they said even they would want me on loan. So I will see the situation, and I will speak to the boss and the coach accordingly, and then I will see if if I don't stand in his plans again this year, then definitely before the I-League I will move to some other club where I know that I will play, because I think I have a good chance of playing in the Indian team if I play.
Would you agree with me when you say you've got less playing time in the I-League and that somehow frustrates you?
Yeah, definitely. I've always performed well for Dempo every time I've started and overcome on. And I've played regularly in the Goa League, which we won every local tournament last year, and even the year before that, we've done very well. And this year also in the I-League, every time I've played, I've done well for the team. And yeah. Sometimes I feel that I should be playing, starting regularly because of my performances. But then it's the coach who decides, and you can't go against it. And whatever he wants is all due respect to him.
The Dempo playmaker had promising trials with a few lower divisional clubs in Germany.
I was supposed to train with Bayer Leverkusen last year because they had an Indian coach, Robin Dutt. But that did not happen because I was there for a short time, and then so the season had ended. But then the other lower league clubs, they train till mid of June, and they have their matches. So I could train with those clubs, and I trained with and I was there with four division clubs and very prominent clubs. So I've trained with them, and they really like me. Then when I went to Sweden to meet another friend, I trained with another second division Swedish club, and I trained there also. So it's very good to train with this club because they're very professional.
And what's the style of football you see over there? Is it the short passing, long passing? What kind of mindset, and what's the physical makeup of these players?
The physical conditioning is very good, and the pace of the game is very fast. So it takes you some time to adjust to the pace of the game, but they are technically so sound that the job is made very easy for everyone. I definitely can make it because I played practice matches with them when I was there, against, and I've scored goals and I've passed, and the coach liked me a lot. And then he asked me whether I was interested in joining, and then my friends there in Germany also spoke to them. But then since I have a contract this year and I'm already here in India, and and now since that I want to just set up in India and play for India, and for that I have to just start playing again here.
Sports reporter Nikhil Pereira and Dinesh Karpe for Prudent Media from Giri.
Toshanche Fest was celebrated at St. Anne's Church at Pathi in Goa Velia. This is one of the unique feasts celebrated in the state. It is believed that the newly married couples or others who are barren of a cucumber asking a grant for a baby. This fest has many other beliefs too. Here are some of the moments captured by the senior video journalist Tuchidas Chari. Thank you. you have missed our bulletin, log on to www.prudentmedia.in or follow us on Twitter at Prudent Goa or meet us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/prudentmedia. With this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Keep watching Prudent Media. Goodbye.